Thank you, Serena. The story was very touching for all of us. I really admire what you and all the fellowship alumni have done in the area. Felt really emotional as well during your life. Next up, we have Mr. Yusuke Tato. He's representing Fukushima, which is a local organization that provides resources for entities working towards rebuilding Fukushima. I think we'll talk more about it. We came all the way here from Japan, so please welcome the tree.
I'm Yusuke Kato. Please support this one. Thank you all for coming to this event, and thank you to CJR for giving me this opportunity, and thank you, UK, for inviting me to my first trip to America. Today, I'd like to talk about the current state of coastal area in Fukushima and our activity. The title of this slide, Kakehashi, do you know that mean? Kakehashi means bridge. Bridge for Fukushima provides study tour in coastal area in Fukushima named Kakehashi Tour to tell the current state of Fukushima and make connection between Fukushima and other areas. Before we start, please look at this picture. This is a picture of Namie Town, which is about 5 kilometers from Fukushima Daiichi Nuclear Power Plant. Shinbeis of the Fukushima are in the center of this picture. And this is one side of the Soso area, the coastal area in northern Fukushima. 100,000 residents evacuated until now. On the other side, so many entrepreneurs started their businesses after the earthquake. The man serving dobujiru, goldfish soup, is a fisherman, Motofumi Kikuchi, from Soma City, the coastal area in Fukushima. He only can fish once in a week, and the kind of fish they can distribute is distributed because of radiation contamination. But he still continued to fish and make kinds of new products after the earthquake. And today, I want to talk about this issue, shortage of human resources and our approach, Kakehashi Tour. Thousands of volunteers, organizations, and companies have come to Soso District during these 3 years. But the reconstruction, revitalization of Fukushima needs so long time and so many kinds of human resources. There are too many problems in Soso area that the nuclear accident caused. And before we start this main topic, I'd like to introduce myself. I'm Yusuke Kato and I'm 25 years old. I'm not a native resident in Fukushima. I'm from Yokosuka, Kanagawa Prefecture, and started to working by using the system of Migyude, right-hand person. The last person, Yuhei, is also a kind of Migyude who works in Ishinomaki, Miyagi Prefecture. Migyude means that the most helpful assistant for leaders in Tohoku area. An NPO whose name is ETIC-ETIC provided this system just after the disaster, and I came to Bridge for Fukushima. And Bridge for Fukushima was made by Kenichi Bamba, he's my boss, who works for developmental aid in Cambodia, Zambia, and Ethiopia. He's from Fukushima, and he came back from Ethiopia just after the earthquake, and Bridge for Fukushima has been started using his network just after the earthquake. And Bridge for Fukushima, just after the earthquake, provided material aid for evacuees, but now we hold study tour networking local NGO under FUNA. And Bridge for Fukushima works in Soso area. At first, we see what happened in Soso area. Fukushima is located the south of, north of Tokyo. It takes about 2 hours by Shinkansen, and the third largest prefecture in Japan. And famous agricultural products include rice, cucumbers, and peaches, and also famous in fishing industry, and also famous has many hot springs. And Fukushima is divided into three districts: Aizu, Nakatomi, and Hamadori. And we work at north of Hamadori called Soso area. And in March 11, 2011, the massive earthquake and tsunami and nuclear power plant accident has occurred in Soso area. A catastrophic failure at Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant on March 11, 2011 resulted in the meltdown of three of the plants of six nuclear reactors. The failure occurred when the plant was hit by a tsunami triggered by a massive earthquake. The plant began releasing substantial amounts of radioactive materials beginning of March 12, becoming the largest nuclear incident since the 1986 Chernobyl disaster and measured as level 7, the highest level on the international nuclear event scale. And please watch this video about the background of the nuclear accident. This video was made by Chishio Furukawa. He's in MIT master course now, and he made this video when he was in Bridge for Fukushima as an internship member.
Was the nuclear accident preventable? TEPCO originally said the accident was caused by the unexpected magnitude of the tsunami. It blamed the accident entirely on the tsunami and claimed it was unaware of the risks. The company called the accident a natural disaster or an act of God, but was it really? Whether the tsunami was the only cause is far from certain. No one can say for sure that the earthquake didn't play a part in the accident. The plant's six reactors needed upgrades worth $800 million to boost their earthquake resistance, but nothing was done for reactors 1 to 3, and the tremor that hit the region on that day was stronger than the projections for the upgrades. Didn't TEPCO know the nuclear plant was at risk? When the first reactor was built in 1974, the risk of a major earthquake or tsunami hitting the region was believed to be low. But later surveys showed that Fukushima was not safe. Why did TEPCO and nuclear regulators fail to adopt sufficient safety measures? Both the company and the regulators were convinced nuclear plants were safe and fail-proof. They believed three safety systems, shutdown, cooling, and containment, would be enough to deal with any emergency. They also gave priority to keeping the reactors running over ensuring their safety. Global standards call for two additional safety measures, preventing radioactive leaks and protecting local residents. But TEPCO and the regulators simply assumed an accident would never occur and ignored the measures. They had plenty of time to take action long before the earthquake and tsunami, yet they postponed anti-earthquake upgrades from 2009 to 2016. By 2006, they knew a large tsunami could cause a serious accident, but they failed to act. Contrary to other countries and international organizations, Japan was putting off safety measures. TEPCO has since admitted that in retrospect, the nuclear plant was not well guarded against accidents. In other words, the Fukushima crisis could have been averted if proper measures had been implemented. So it's reasonable to say the disaster was man-made. Was the nuclear accident preventable? TEPCO originally said the accident...
As you see in the movie, the resident in this area believed that nuclear power plant was safe. An accident will never occur, but the accident occurred. And this is an area with needed evacuation. First, the government announced that residents within the 3 kilometers radius from Fukushima Daiichi nuclear plant need to evacuate. The circle gradually get bigger, and finally, the 20-kilometer radius had to evacuate. 100,000 people still need to evacuate until now from this area. No one lives in this area. So the town in this area, just like the ghost town, as you saw in other presentation movies, they cannot fish nor farm. And I want to say that contamination level is not in proportion to the distance from Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. For example, Itate village, which is about 50 kilometers from nuclear plant, was highly contaminated. On the other hand, the coastal area of Namie is green zone. The green zone means that not so highly contaminated, but the place is about 5 kilometers from nuclear plant. So what it caused to this area? Next, I talk about problems that were caused after the disaster in this area and explain why human resource shortage has occurred and is so severe. I think there are two reasons why human resource shortage occurred. First, as you can see the evacuation map, 100,000 people have evacuated from this area. And add to that, this accident causes thousands of problems in this area, and the problem is so complicated. And radiation has no color, no odor. Radiation is invisible. So the government monitors the radiation level in the air and monitor each vegetables and fish harvested in Fukushima. And decontamination of town is implemented by the government by removing dirty soil. But the inhabitants continue to feel uneasiness despite the radiation level is gradually decreased. After the accident, the government said the reactor is okay, the reactor is okay, no problem, but resulted in evacuation and contamination. And the contaminated water continued to leak. The residents don't believe what the government and media said anymore. For example, our survey to the inhabitants in Soma City, which is located 550 kilometers from nuclear power plant, showed that the residents who have small town still don't use tap water, despite the administration said the tap water is safe because they monitored. It is true that the tap water is not contaminated, but the residents still feel uneasiness that the tap water must be contaminated, and the administration must be considering something. And the TEPCO, which is the owner of the Fukushima Daiichi, provides compensations for those who lost their jobs due to the 3.11. And yes, that is necessary, but that leads to the lack of motivation to work. For example, most of fishermen cannot go to fishery due to radiation contamination. The fishery only once in a week, and the fishery area is also restricted. The fish must be passed by the radiation contamination checks. The gross landing fish is far from the amount before the disaster, the fishermen cannot make a living by fishing industry itself, but they don't have to go to find a other job because they have compensation from TEPCO. So they lost their work. So they lost their will to work, but they feel uneasiness that they cannot live if the compensation ends. Uneasiness and distrust affect the price of food that was harvested in Fukushima. For example, please look at this chart. This is the price of peach made in Fukushima. The price of peach made in Fukushima was decreased 70% between 2010 and 2011. The food that was made in Fukushima are monitored and distributed only the cleared safe product, and the rate of cleared safe product is 99%, despite using the most strict standards all over the world, but the stigma still remains. The evacuees don't know when they can come back to their hometown, and they don't know they can come back or not. After the earthquake, the more problem increases, the more people we need. For example, this is the image of public service in Soso area. After the nuclear accident, the public service in this area was rapidly increased, and each organization tried to solve the increased problem, but the power is far from enough to solve vast number of problems and complicated problems that we haven't encountered before. We need more supporter, follower, and entrepreneur in this area. And the population itself has decreased in this area because of evacuation, especially the young people who have small child. We need to get supporter, follower, and entrepreneur from other area. On the other hand, we realize that the immigrated people, just like me, need to co-work with the local resident in this area to solve the problem. We need to encourage their challenges. So, Youth for Fukushima started Kakehashi Tour to bridge between Soso area with other area. I introduced Kakehashi Tour in detail. This tour is expected to connect the local entrepreneur and tourist by seeing the problems in this area. The local entrepreneurs have their own work, for example, fishery, creating processed marine food, holding workshop, preparing back to the evacuation area, etc. First, we see Tonko Kusaka, a member of only the NPO in Shinchitaro. The Terumi Kawakami is also from Shinchitaro, who Jake introduced. In Shinchitaro, about town development is over 50 kilometers from nuclear power plant. Tomoko runs a small wholesale company in Shinchitaro, and after the earthquake, she created the only NPO with local friends to develop her hometown. Shinchitaro is next to Miyagi Prefecture and located in the northern section of Hamadori. The population is about 8,000. This building was used as fish market before the earthquake. They listened to what occurred on March 11th. And generally, recovering efforts in Fukushima are delayed compared to Iwate and Miyagi Prefecture, but Shinchitaro quickly obtained agreement from all its residents to transfer residential areas to higher ground by repeated workshop with local residents and the administration. For example, it is currently working to establish Job Cafe to introduce local companies via its website and to enhance the community of young working people. In Soma City, 50 kilometers from nuclear power plant, Nagamasa Takahashi started to create new processed marine food after the earthquake. There are family of Nagamasa Takahashi. The center wearing orange shirt is Nagamasa, and the left is Keiko, his wife, and Hiroe, his daughter, and Hiroyoshi, his son. Fortunately, his family are all safe, despite Hiroe and Nagamasa's mother was swallowed by tsunami. But his factory, office, and his house were lost. Nagamasa is guiding the coastal area in Soma City. There was a beautiful beach in this area, but the tsunami and earthquake destroyed the beach. At that, and the beach was highly contaminated by radiation. Just after the earthquake, he started a morning market called Asaichi in Soma City. But the stigma for food in Fukushima is so severe. Now he started to create processed marine food using fish from other places. Fishermen also struggled in this severe situation. Motofumi Kikuchi is a fisherman in Soma City, and he has his own fishing boat. The fish was caught by him. As I mentioned before, most of fishermen cannot go to fishery due to radiation contamination. So fishery only once in a week, and the fishery area is also restricted. The kind of fish is also restricted. The fish must be passed radiation checks. The restricted fish includes the most delicious fish in this area. And Motofumi worries that if he and his friends, his fishermen friends, stop to fish, the marine culture in this area must be ended. So he started to create new processed marine food in this area. His fishermen, he can live by compensation from TEPCO, as I said before, but he works. Because his fishery is his life, and he don't want to leave Soma City, though he can do the fishing industry in other prefectures. And Minami Soma City, which is 40 kilometers to 30 kilometers from nuclear plant, Minami Soma City was divided into three areas, Kashima, Haramachi, and Odaka. He is in Kashima, and the residents didn't need to evacuate it after the earthquake, after the accident. Though he lost many of his loyal customers because of earthquake and tsunami, and was hit hard by negative rumors due to the nuclear power plant disaster, he continues to make miso, soybeans paste, from a recipe that has been handed down for generations to generations. As a member of community firefighting team, he participated in rescue operations and the search for dead bodies immediately after the earthquake. He can talk about how the nuclear power plant disaster affected rescue operations and how it affected the town thereafter. He has wife and daughter. They were evacuated for fear of radiation because wife just gave birth to her daughter. Now they are back and live in Kashima. And the last is Odaka, 20 kilometers to 10 kilometers from the nuclear power plant. The Tomoko Kobayashi, Jake introduced, is also lived before. Odaka is evacuation area. No one is there. Shizuka Kume is the local resident in Odaka, Minami Soma City. She runs a small company near to the sea, so her office was damaged. When she cleaned the damaged office on March 12, 2011, she witnessed the white smoke and heard the explosion. She asked his husband, "What is that, gas station?" But the smoke and sound was from the nuclear power plant. She lives in Soma City now because she needed to evacuate. She settled new NGO for preparing back to Odaka and tells her story after the accident to get supporters. And local residents have mixed feelings about study tour in evacuation area. But our main purpose is to revitalize the local economy and assist reconstruction. We focused on the personal history and challenges in coastal area in Fukushima. The challenges in Fukushima tell the situation after the earthquake until now. So we call it human tourism. Please see a movie about Shizuka and our tour. In this movie, they enter Odaka and Namie town, which is 5 kilometers from Yokuyo Pipeline.
Visits the affected area to create a support group. So, we need to have people come here to see the situation with their own eyes. And we also found it necessary for local people who are fully aware of the situation to join us. They can serve as a tourism resource because we can organize tours with them as the leading figures.
Japan is a country which has experienced a nuclear accident. Alexei wants to talk with some of the victims in Fukushima in person.
People in Belarus have experienced village-wide evacuations. The tragedy experienced at Chernobyl has been repeated here in Japan. I think the Belarusian people can feel the tragedy of Fukushima more keenly than anyone.
Alexei has asked Shizuka Kume to take him on a dark tour to visit the afflicted areas.
Can you see the flashing lights on that police car over there? This is within a 10-kilometer radius. The restriction was finally lifted on April 1st.
On this tour, visitors usually travel around the coastal areas where many places are designated as an evacuation zone. Shizuka has been hospitalized due to the stress from the repeated evacuations and contamination caused by radiation.
What made you become a tour guide?
Many visitors were expected to come. I was asked whether I would become a tour guide, and I decided to try it. When I started showing people around, I began to talk about my personal experiences, and through being able to talk like that, I've become able to sort out my feelings better, and that has helped to reduce my feelings of stress.
On this tour, you can even visit a no-go area. The organizer gets permission from the local government beforehand. From this point on, no public vehicles are allowed access.
This area has been left untouched. From here, the scene changes dramatically. It's just the way it was on March 11, 2 years ago.
Alexei sees heartbreaking traces of the disaster. In this area, around 600 households were completely destroyed by the tsunami. On the following day, an evacuation order was issued so that every resident had to evacuate. More than 1 month passed before search efforts for missing people finally began here. Since then, debris removal and decontamination have barely progressed. Chernobyl was open to tourists 25 years after the accident, so Alexei can't help thinking it's been only 2 years here in Fukushima. The Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant is located just 5 kilometers away. You can see it with the naked eye. Alexei meets a woman who used to live around here.
My family has been broken apart. But if I come here, I can feel the bonds with them. So whenever I feel lonely, I come here.
Would you like many tourists to visit here?
Well, I have mixed feelings. I want people to see it, but I don't want them to make fun of the place. So I'm a bit confused. I realized for the first time how awful the plan was. I believe the myth of its infallible safety. Even though I live side by side with it, I never had any doubts and enjoyed a normal lifestyle. But just one single explosion changed my whole life. That's how threatening this nuclear power plant really was.
Beside the road, there's a small memorial monument where visitors can offer a prayer. Since the accident, Shizuka has had to move from one evacuation center to another 6 times, and her family members are still living in different places. This is a reality that no one wants to face, but that very fact drives her on to tell others about it.
Tours of disaster-stricken areas are called dark tourism. A dark tour is a very delicate kind of matter because the ideology of its construction, assistance, and personal hardship conflict with one another. Making a balance is very important. If we lose the balance, it will leave deep scars. We have to consider various things. But the goal of our tour is to get supporters, followers, and entrepreneurs to this area. We focused on the personal history and challenges in social area. The local entrepreneurs explain the social area to get human resource, and the local entrepreneurs themselves are encouraged through communication with tourists. So we call our tour human tourism. And I want to say that I am also one of the supporters for the local resident in social area and one of followers to the passionate local challenges in social area, just like Kenichi Bamba, who is my boss. And of course, one of entrepreneur in social area because I decided to immigrate and started Kakehashi Tour at early date in 2012. And I want to say, I want all to come to social area. And please change social area into more excellent area. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Yusuke. I had the great opportunity to also visit Fukushima this past summer. I spent a week and I got to visit a similar area to where you visited. And I went last summer and I don't know when those pictures were taken in that video, but it was also left untreated. I saw cars and broken down houses, totally abandoned area. So I wonder, I'm just curious when that would get fixed.